This is Vidiotheque, where every week we try to help you get the most out of your internet marketing efforts. I'm Scott Combs. If you're running a business, chances are you've done your share of marketing and sales. Salespeople fall into different style categories. Whether it's 4, 5, or 7 styles is immaterial for our discussion. We've all heard about consultative sales, relational sales, the closer, who starts closing the deal while they're shaking your hand, and of course, the educator. Which sales style is best for your website? That's easy. It's the educator. The educator knows the product inside and out and seeks to give the prospect a thorough understanding so they're comfortable with their decision. As a salesperson, I was known as the educator, and it was seen as a disadvantage by my boss, whose sales motto could be summed up in one word: close, close, close. Which created an adversarial sales process I hated. I was interested in making sure my customers understood and loved the products they were buying. Sure, I sold fewer units than my colleagues, but took a fraction of their kicks or returns. As a result, I was consistently at the top of my sales ladder and taking home more money than the rest. One of our clients has always been an educator. His products and services are big ticket items, and he wants to make sure his customers have as much information as they need to make an informed decision. This has served him very well in his online presence, garnering returns on investment between 625 and 1,000%. Sales trainers will point out that educators on your sales force run the risk of sharing too much information and losing the sale. But your website is not a salesperson. Online, your prospects and customers are in charge of how much information they want and can handle. Which means your website must be ready with all the information your prospects could possibly want. Now, it's common for businesses to leave some information out so people will call and engage with a salesperson. This appears to be counterproductive. Studies and surveys consistently show website visitors want enough information to make a buying decision on your website. That calls for comprehensive content. Spec sheets, brochures, blogs, information on how to use the products, troubleshooting tips, testimonials, anything you can think of that answers questions your prospects ask. And since the discovery process is self-directed, you don't run the risk of a salesperson wrecking the deal by saying too much. To be sure, this is a new way of thinking about your business's web presence, but the track record of content marketing across the online universe is testimony to this point of view. Forget about what all these self-proclaimed experts are saying. Rather, pay attention to what your prospects and customers are responding to. Now, you can choose to ignore them and keep doing things the way you've always done them, running the risk your online business will never develop or will simply dry up as your competitors offer content and information your customers want. Your choice. If you like our stuff, click the subscribe button so you can be automatically notified when we post a new video. Leave comments, questions, and more on the blog, at YouTube, or at the email address on the screen. Thanks for watching. Now get out and do something.